Today's lesson is going to involve a little bit of review of last night's homework, Lie and Lay. We'll do a little practice with sit and set, and then we'll talk about our next set of troublesome verbs, rise and raise. Why don't we take a moment and begin with a prayer in the name of the Father, and the Son, the Holy Spirit, amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. The Father, and the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. So here you have a little review of last night's homework with lie and lay. And we will always want to remember that lie will not take a direct object. It's four principal parts. Lie is the base form. Lying is the present participle form. Lay is the past form, and have lain is the past participle form. For lay is the base form. Laying is the present participle form. Laid is the past, and have laid is the past participle form. And you can see with the verbs that lay will take a DL, lie will not, and wherever you used lay, I always circled that DO. The only trick would be in number 20. And that was because it's actually in a verb. It's an predicate adjective. You have the linking verb was there. So you're actually using the linking verb there. You're using it as a predicate adjective. So the linking verb there, you're going to use lay. That would be the one time where it's not used as a with a direct object is what I'm saying. So those are the troublesome verbs for answers for the worksheet, lie and lay. All right. So next what we wanted to do, if you go into your DoNet worksheets, there's one with sit and set. And you might want to take a moment and press pause and download that. Go ahead and do it. And then after you get it done, take a moment and I'll review the answers. Okay, the forms of sit and set are pretty straightforward. You have sit, sitting, sat, and have sat. Sit will never take a DL. And then you have set, which is set, setting, set, and have set. So we always want to remember set has a DL, okay? And sit is not going to be a direct object, okay? So here we go. Number one, was Oscar, and we want to use sitting on top of the shed so he could repair the shingles. Right. Number two, we want to say don't sit in the direct sunlight for too long. For number three, Uncle Robert set out the tools he would need for the day's job, and we're going to use tools, so we use set, so we have a DL. For number four, should Aunt Beverly set the travel brochures on the kitchen counter? All right. So brochures is our DO, and that's why we use a form of set. For five, for the first 2 weeks of class, you may, and we want to use sit wherever you wish. For number six, Jarrell will be setting the props in the hall, so we will know what we should change or add for each performance. Now we're going to have a DO for using setting, and that DO is props. For seven, by the way, Nelda always sets a beautiful table and delicious meal, so we have a DO, and it's actually a compound DO. It's table and meal. For number eight, Albert has set up his own automotive repair shop. All right, shop's your DO, so we have a DO because we use set. For nine, I had been sitting for too long and my foot became stiff. So we're going to use sitting, there's no DO. And the last one, number 10, the county commissioner who sat in the center favored the highway's location. All right, so we noticed that if we use any form of Sit, we're not going to have a direct object. If we use any form of set, we always have a DO. So now in exercise B, what we want to do is fill in our correct forms for each one. So when I do it on the side here, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay. So number 11 is going to be sat. Okay, we don't have a DO. Okay, for number 12, we want to use a present participle form because we have a form of B in front of it. We have R. And we're going to use setting, okay, because we are going to have a DO. And that's going to be root. Okay, for number 13, we're going to use set, okay, because we're going to have a DO. That's going to be goals. Okay, for 14, we're going to use set again, okay, and we're going to have a DO again, all right, and that's going to be plates, glasses, and silverware. All right, and the last one, we need a present participle form, and we're going to go with sitting. There's no DO. All right, so those are the correct answers for the Do Now worksheet. Hopefully you got them right. If you have any questions on that, by all means, feel free to email me about them. And what I wanted to focus on today's lesson is last set troublesome verbs, and those two are going to be rise and raise. So when we use rise, we mean to go up or to get up. And its principal parts, the base form is rise. Present participle form is rising. The past of rise is rose. Okay. And then the past participle form is have risen. Okay. Rise will never take a DO. And then we have raise, which means to lift up or to cause something to rise. And because we're lifting up or causing something to rise, it's going to take a DO. And the four principal parts of raise, you have raise, you have is raising. Okay, you have raised. And then you have raised. Okay, and the key thing to remember, raise will take a DO, but rise will not take a DO. Okay, so those are your principal parts. Now we'll take a moment, and if you press pause, you can figure out which ones are the correct forms, okay? Once you get done with those, you can press play again, and you can figure out what the correct answers are. For number one, the first one is going to be our landlord raises, okay? That's the correct verb, and we have rent as our DO. Okay, for number two, I always want to say rise early. Okay, there's no DO, so that's why we're using rise. All right, for number three, we have to use a past form, the price index, and we're going to say rose sharply. Okay, again, no DO. And then the last one, the balloons are, we want to say rising. We need a present participle form because we have a form of B in front of it. Okay, so those are the forms of rise and raise. All right, tonight you don't have any homework that's due Wednesday because Wednesday is the day of prayer. So the homework assignment I gave for you is due Thursday. All right, I'll also for that Thursday assignment attach that take-home quiz. Again, do it on your own. You don't have to submit it to me. And in Thursday's lesson, I'll take time and go over the answers. You have rules on apostrophes, 8 to 11, and then you have weak and indefinite pronoun reference, and all you have to do is just read through the sentence. If the sentence has clear reference, if it's correct, you're going to put A, and if it has unclear reference, if it's incorrect, you're going to put B. A different way, I asked the quiz this time, Okay. So good luck on that quiz. I'll take some time on Thursday to go over that. And then you can make sure you hand in all your homework and enjoy that day of prayer tomorrow. You can tune into kellenberg.org and you'll be able to follow along with the day of prayer. Have a good day.